Hey guys, it's Tammy here and I've got our cat Patches with me today, and you're probably wondering, why is there a cat in a nursing video? Well, that's because this little sweetie pie has been diagnosed with diabetes, and we're talking about blood glucose testing today, and we're gonna do that right after this. Welcome back, my name is Tammy and this is Nurse Minder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. So we're not actually talking about pet testing, although I will share with you that I have learned, just as an aside, for those of you who are also living with a pet that is diabetic, this little machine here, the Accu-chek guide, I ordered it to see if it would be comparable to the Pet Pro. Definitely comparable, the exact same reading when I did a glucose test, and way cheaper. So that's an aside. We're going to talk more about testing on humans and how to use your glucometer. In this case, it's the Accu-chek guide. Now the way your machine will work may look a little different, but the steps will be the same whether you're working at home or in a clinical setting. So let's get started. Now, taking a blood glucose test is not that difficult, but there are some important things to note before we get started. Number one is preparation, getting ready for the blood test. Number two, the lancing device and getting that ready to go. Then we're going to look at getting your glucometer ready to accept the blood, actually obtaining a blood sample, and then what to do after you get those readings. Now, the first thing we need to talk about is preparing your skin. Today, we're going to focus on the fingers, jazz hands. Okay, all funniness aside, preparing your fingers for a glucose test means we need to clean them. Now this can be with soap and water, or you can use an alcohol pad, or if you're using the hand sanitizer to clean your hands, that would be fine as well. There is one important caveat. If you're using alcohol swab or hand sanitizer, you must waste that first little bleb of blood that you get because it can be contaminated with the alcohol in the swabs and give you a false reading. Now there's a few reasons why we want to clean our hands. One, obviously we want to get rid of any debris that might influence the reading. You know, that chocolate bar you may have just had, or you've just had some dinner and you haven't cleaned your hands yet, there can be residue. Two, it helps to warm up the hands and get the blood flowing so that you're more likely to get a nice bleb, we call it, a little bubble of blood to get your sample. And then number three, super important, is we're puncturing the skin, and our skin is our first defense against infection. So we want to make sure that we are not accidentally puncturing through a dirty area and potentially increasing the risk for infection. So there's three really good reasons why to prepare your hands before you do your test. Setting up your lancing device, let's first talk about the elements of this particular device. We have a cap. And this is where we're going to pull off to insert our lancet, but it's also where we dial up the depth of our injection. So it goes from a 0.5 and it can go all the way up to a 5.5. Okay, now they say if you're new to testing your sugars, the recommended start would be at a 2. So we're going to leave that at a 2. We're now going to pull off the cap. And you'll see that there's a place to insert here. We're going to insert until we hear a click. We're going to twist this off and pull, and it exposes the needle. Replacing our cap by lining up the lines here. The next thing we need to do is to prime the pen. And we're simply going to press the end here, and what you're going to notice now is that this here is an indicator light, it will change to yellow. The lancet is now loaded and ready to be dispensed. So now that we've washed our hands, we're going to get our Accu-chek reader prepared. We simply need to take one of our testing strips. Go. And we're going to insert the chip into the machine. You'll just see it comes on. It's now ready for our blood. We're going to want to select on the side, and we'll just select this finger here. Press firmly, but not so hard, and then depress the ejector.
squeeze that finger. You may need to do what we call milking it to get a reasonable size sample. And then apply it to the tip.
Now, when you go to CanadaDiabetes.ca, they talk about the normal values for blood sugar being between 4 and 7 before you eat, and then 2 hours after you eat between 5 and 10. All right, so I wanted to add on to this video and do a little demonstration. Sometimes I find that our patients' hands are not really clean when we do a test, and I want to see if that actually impacts reading. So I have a little syrup here, I'm going to put it on my finger, and I'm going to come back and test it after it's dry. So stay tuned for that. Okay, so there's just enough syrup right here. I'm going to put that on my finger and it's all tacky now. Let that dry and we'll come back and test this finger in a minute. Okay, so this finger got really sticky. I did just kind of wipe a wee bit off, but there is still a little bit there. So let's see how this test will go. All right, so let's get our pen ready. Remove the cap. Insert your lancing device till you hear the click. Twist off. And remove or re-establish the cap, lining up this hole with this line. I'm going to dial up to 2 because that worked well for me. And prime my lancing device. It is now ready to go. Take my testing strip. Insert it into the device. Wait for that to tell me it's ready, and it's ready to go. Now this is the finger that I had the syrup on, and I've kind of cleaned it a little bit, so let's see if this is going to make a difference in my reading. Pick one of the sides of the finger, so the pad. Avoid the center piece, we want to go onto the side. Gentle pressure and depress. Now we're going to milk or strip. And I'm not going to get rid of this piece of blood because I want to see if that sugar is going to make a difference. Bring it towards the yellow piece. And let's see what happens. 10.0. That's a significant change from 4.9. And that was just a little bit of syrup left on my fingers. You can see it looks clean. You can't tell that there was syrup on there. It feels smooth, so make sure you're cleaning your hands before you take your test. And then, of course, we want to remove our cap. Transition the ejector cap forward. That just slid off my desk. And then recap it. Clean all of this and you're done. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned a ton because it was an awful lot of fun bringing this video to you. Make sure you subscribe below so you're in line for the next video when it's released. Hit that like button and write me a comment. Let me know what you think of this video. If you have some ideas, I'd like to hear them as well. Until next time, make it a great day.
Hey, I know you're probably not ready to get off your phone or go back to work just yet, or maybe even turn the lights off to go to sleep. So why don't you spend a little bit more time here watching another video?